So within 2 minutes, I'll just sum up what we learned today. First, I think it's important, just again, the genesis of this event, from crisis can lead to cannibalization within our space and fighting for slack resources and attention and time. I think the Alliance is the embodiment of a different course that we've chosen to take. From crisis has come collaboration and exchange of ideas and comparing and contrasting what we know, what we don't know, and it culminates in sessions like this that are very informative and mature for our space. That's the first thing. The second thing, I would just want to underscore what Lisa said and not forget why we're here. Would all of the non-housing counselors in the room please join me in applause again for them, because they're in the front lines of this trench warfare. Thank you very much. I know it's hand-to-hand battle on behalf of clients in need and at risk, and case management is the way forward. Let's just remember that for the next battle that we have to fight. So what do we learn? One, we learned that this town writ large tends to have a monopoly on thinking and understanding. But I think we've kind of debunked that. There's a lot of interesting things, innovative things that are going on in the field, as it were. And so I think that's something, again, this is a different kind of session, learning and exchange of ideas in a way that can reinforce what we know and how the national intermediaries in this town are supporting our frontline troops in that sense. We heard from Janet Merguia earlier that, again, the housing crisis is far from over. It's a dynamic, fluid, ever-changing crisis. And as we encounter the next wave of this, I think it's going to take us, again, collaborating, coming closer, and activating what we've learned here through prior experiences. The Attorney General Joe Smith mentioned, and through the settlement, that this is a strong move forward, but it's just the beginning. I would only add, I don't think it's the beginning. I think we are now far enough into this that we're in the middle of something, and the framework for the settlement essentially is a ship at sea that will never reach port. This is the model moving forward. Now we need to improve it, tinker with the margins, and use it as we're talking about the tobacco settlement and the S&L crisis. How do we hold folks accountable, and what mechanisms can we build that are sustainable for the next generation of fights that we encounter? The next thing is that there are certain core principles that this collaborative and everyone in the room should adhere to and be challenged around, and that has to do with improvements to future settlements, as was mentioned by the panel. And I just want to kind of just sum up where the Alliance is on this very question. Strong enforcement of the various settlements is essential to restoring the public's faith in our housing system. Any settlement should include a data collection and public reporting component, as was mentioned, Araceli brought this up, as well as more transparency from the services around who qualifies for principal reduction and other foreclosure mitigation strategies that will keep borrowers in their homes. That really is the essential underline for the event today. How do we kind of rebuild, stabilize household balance sheets and neighborhood stabilization at the same time? But the justice question, I think, is still unsettled here. We need to come to understanding as to what that means within this particular context. I mentioned, will there be blood? But I think you understand what I'm saying. I think, absent a perp walk, right, what is the accountability, the public consumer-facing element to this? Where is it? We heard from Joe Smith. He talked about the industry needs a reboot. He did show his work and how he approaches his challenge, but I think it is a work in progress. I think we would all concede, and I think we're all key to look at his third report. He mentioned the intentionality of the settlement, access to data, and the appropriate units of analysis. Araceli talked about disproportionality spatially, but also sociodemographically. I think we have to be more finely tuned in how we talk about these communities that have been left behind within this crisis. And again, this is another iteration of that conversation. We talked about investors, particularly in the Midwest, Cleveland, buying up properties. That is germane to this question and problem as well, around what our communities will end up looking like, this experience theme I mentioned earlier. What do we go ahead and do with this information, I think will bear fruit for communities that are on the brink. We're losing them. We're losing the Detroits. We're losing other smaller and tertiary-sized cities in the Midwest. I think we need to look at that. Araceli was going to write a prescription for Paxil for the broader financial services sector. I think that might be something good. We also heard around banks pimping for balance sheets. I haven't used that term in several weeks. It's nice to be able to say pimping during the daylight. So I think that was very, very nice to bring that out. But we also heard that the AG settlement is not an arrow in the quiver of housing counselors that we thought it would be or should be. And I think that transparency issue is as yet resolved. We talked about short sales here. I think that's the next wave of this crisis, the easy way out for banks. And the marketing around that convincing clients that it's their easy way out. And I think that's something we need to have a better understanding around, where the bright line is and that balance. The last thing I'd say is the alliance itself. We are going through changes as well, and we are contemplating, you know, an alliance 2.0. What's the next challenge for us to speed towards as an ambulance or as a fire truck to be part of the triage and emergency response? So we're trying to understand where our advocacy resides and how we can continue to bring the spotlight on these issues. And the last thing I want to say is that we are a tripartite relationship with Capacity and NCLR. I think NCLR deserves a lot of credit for actually being in the vanguard, in the forefront, and they are an immense force for good in this space. And I wanted really to praise NCLR for hosting us and being very generous with what they know and who they partner with. That's been very helpful. So again, we want all of us to evangelize this work, what we've learned and what we have yet to learn, but I think we should go forth and continue to bring folks under this rather large tent and expanding tent that we have here, trying to talk about communities of color, trying to talk about how we build wealth, preserve it, and set our kids up for a far better society that we've inherited. So thank you very, very much. And again, watch this space. Thank you.